Today's video is sponsored by Omaze. Visit omaze.com/L&M. We're Ladi and Margaret, and we love e-bikes, campervans, and cats.
Nice.
We've been harnessing up all of our creative energy to build the most unique and advanced campervan that we're capable of. Our van will be our full-time tiny home on wheels, and we'll use it to travel the globe with our little Milikua. With the help of our newly renovated workshop in a tiny village of Czech Republic, we're moving forward with the interior. To see this van go from DPD delivery to our dream creation, subscribe to the channel. It really helps us out, and we'd love for you to join us for the journey. Ready, Millie? I'm slicing up a bunch of sound deadening for the floor. We have 70 of these tiny strips. We're gonna have 24 of this width and another 14 over there. And that will like make it nice and quiet when we're driving around, which is always the goal.
It's gonna make it good. And for all of you people over obsessed with the weight, obviously we wanna stay under 3.5 ton. But these things are pretty actually heavy. So look at that. There's just a few of them. And here you have it, 2 kilos right away. So this is roughly 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18, easily 20 kilos for noise deadening alone, just for the floor.
I never would have expected that, right? That's
and cool. Look at that, how much we have in there. I bet this could easily be 40 kilos. Is it worth it? Yes. Jenny had the doors off, the radio loud. The night was too cold for t-shirts, but too late now. There's nothing like freedom.
All painted.
16 years old, driving till the sky starts turning. Look at this cute little roller. It's like a little foam, so it beautifully does this curving and these edges. Wow, that is a nice, pleasing job. Thank you. I have this plastic channel specifically for wires. And because we have the power bank in the middle here, So to prevent running all these thick wires all the way visible, I'm gonna run them under the floor. So this will help me a lot. So I wanna go really close to the side, because I know it's gonna go in between the insulation, all the wires. And the same thing on the other side. I put it a little bit closer to this side because I know everything and main wiring will go this way, because that's where gonna be panel, that's where everything is gonna be. And then I can easily run a string to pull all the cables through, or I can just take it, fill it in, and then cover it properly.
Recognize this floor? We got really lucky and this came with the van, and we are going to use it.
I definitely would be able to save a few kilos by using lightened plywood, but that's just the whole sheet and making it all over again for 5 kilos. I'll just use this one, make a template, cut one of these holes, cut out 10 of them, transfer to the same thickness plywood, glue them in overnight, and next day we have a whole sheet ready.
Ještě druhou stranu. Druhou stranu taky poškrábem. No, ahoj. No. A ty jsi mázel. Ty jsi mázel, že? No. Ježíš Maria, no, mázel.
I love this glue. Do you see how it bubbled out? How it expands and fills all these gaps? That's pretty nice. And now I can just scrape it.
Great.
That is a neat job. Can't even feel it. It's perfectly flush. That shed swallowed all the packing material that always comes handy. Give me more space. I'm expecting a lot of mess from DPD drivers.
Loaded.
They left us some candy. Like many villages in the region, this village has fruit trees planted just about everywhere, including in the community spaces. All of these flowering trees are cherry trees, and it's common for everyone in this small community to grab a handful or even a basketful when you go for a walk around town. Most people have cherries in their yards too, so there is no shortage. This is one of the random plots next to the road that has about 30 cherry trees. The old men of the village usually bring their own ladders for picking, knowing full well that the best cherries are always at the top.
In exchange with having a moderately squished toilet,
that it needs to be compromised. Definitely that space. That's only for one purpose. That needs to be compromised a lot. So it's a camper van.
I would rather bring this in even further here to have more space in the hallway, because that's what we're using more than the bathroom, frankly. Then, so if we keep that this size, okay, then reluctantly, I'd want to move the counter in a little bit.
In?
Yeah.
To the wall?
Yeah.
I agree.
What if? Ooh, that's kind of an idea.
Wow, that's some pro cabinet making happening right here. So we have it. We have a line and we have outline, so we know where the shower goes.
To give a little idea of why this is happening the way it is, this is a high impact area. This is where you're going and touching when you go both in and out of the van. So there needs to be a really sturdy piece of wood there so the floor doesn't like dip or bend or morph or anything when you're going in and out so consistently. Because a lot of people will have it where their floors start to kind of bow because of being in high pressure, high impact areas. So that's what Ladi's avoiding.
This is purposely oak hardwood, and I didn't want any self-tapping screws to go through this and be sticking out here. So I went for screws from below. Now this most stressed part that is always stepped on and always stressed the most has extra support. So I'm choosing where to put those supports. Look, now it's very easy for me to work because I have the same width. Go like this, then I can go hard against, no measurements needed, drill, screw, bang. And then I have these spacers and I'm gonna be using them where I need the floor to be stiffer. Same width like the insulation. So it goes bang, bang, bang. And I'll be choosing to probably put one here, second one here, because this is the most stressed path essentially you take every single time. We're gonna be making the step again like we had in last van. That was absolutely amazing, and you never step really close to objects. Notice that. So this looks like perfect that you always step right here, roughly.
Tail up. Ciao, Alina. Hi. Wet. Yeah, I know. I see. We're gonna need to do some paw wiping when we get home. And we know how much you hate that. You need one more touches? Come on. But you're very dirty.
I'm using this glue. This is good for wood to wood. Nicely goes through all the pores and holds it really well. And then I'm using Mammoth to attach it to the metal. Mammoth is gonna sort it out for sure. I was kind of paranoid for a long time, screwing too much to the floor itself. It just increases the chance of a rust. I did it before, it's nothing wrong with the technique, a lot of people do it, and it's definitely faster than this. But in this case, I actually have all the pieces screwed together and glued together, so it creates like one unified piece, and all over the place, it's glued to the floor. So I'm using self-tapping screws, so far I used two, where I really want to tighten it down to the floor, or where I need to be screwing to the floor later, something heavier. Notice the pattern where we walk or where we have a heavy cargo like these batteries. It's more dense, not to have any bowing in the floor. I'm happy with this, that turned out pretty good. You know why I like it, cutting on a saw? Because all of these are nicely square, all of it, and they're always pretty tight together. Not like cutting with a knife, then you have it on an angle, not a perfect contact. This worked out pretty well. And then these pipes hidden below the floor, insulated, and then I just staple the strap to hold it in, and then I'm gonna do a cutout in the floor and just tighten it there. And then all of these wheel arches, they're gonna be actually built around, so everything will hide right here. That'll be good. I'm happy with this.
Ladi said not to touch, but look how squishy it is. Squish, squish. Oh my gosh, this is so fun. Look at it. Wow.
I told you not to touch.
I didn't. This is for one of the local strays, Mikej. Mikej is a very old, very battered, stray black cat that lives in the neighborhood. There are a few strays, and they are so nervous around humans that the second they see that you see them, they are completely gone. And it's been so rainy, and I'm a little embarrassed I didn't do it earlier, but we set up a little spot for him because Millie's not really made this her territory yet, and we didn't want to feed Mikej at the family home because then he'll start thinking that's his territory and Millie and Montes are there. So we have this little spot for him when it's raining. As you can tell, we've needed to catch some cover because it has started to rain.
The foam is now cured, nice and hard, so I can cut it nice and flash and move on and bring the floor. Hey, don't forget, this is a like a sealant. This is not a foam itself that you would use for insulation. This is for insulating water piping system. The difference is that this one doesn't absorb moisture, so with time it won't rust through the car. Okay, so once this is done, you can go around and do the vapor barrier.
Okay.
All around.
She got that 60s Midwest cool, the kind of make a smart man. Take you right to school, baby. And now I wanna follow all her rules. Oh, you know she got me coming back again. I lose my mind and phone a friend. I know this is the end. She got me saying, oh my. I gotta show off some of these Ladi perfectionist details. Here's the water pipes, and those will then be flush against the wheel wells later on. Then you got this tiny cutout for the wires, followed by this one in the middle. Oops, you can already see my footprints. Followed by this one, wires too. This looks so much better than I thought it would. It seriously feels perfect.
I'm very happy how this floor turned out. There's definitely multiple ways how to do it. This works well for us, and it will definitely be a good foundation for the whole van.
And if you made it this far into the video, thank you so much for joining us. Please like the video, subscribe to the channel, and drop a comment below and let us know what you're up to this weekend. And I think we'll see everybody next time for the next installment.